YouTube, welcome back to the channel. I'm your host TKK and we are back with another video. I got my favorite right here. This is my old girl. You go ahead on that direction. Yeah. This is my old girl right here. You can go ahead on circle around me. Gotta clean her up. We call this the C2. Hopefully you guys doing good. Listen, man, I shot that video earlier right here for you guys. Thank you, man. That thing is up there for me. Appreciate it. I had a dude walk up to me today and ask me if I was on YouTube. I'm like, what? First, I told him, I don't know what he's talking about, but you know. But anyway, I just came from grinding, making my paper for the day. And, you know, I'm just sitting here thinking about this girl right here. C2 OLED. Man, listen, there's something about this type of technology that I don't think a lot of you guys are just, you're probably not going to understand it. But we're going to get into that right after this intro. All right, guys, welcome back to the channel. Man, look, we're not doing no blind picking. We got 55 class LG C2 on the left, 65 class Sony Alpha 95 King in the middle, 55 class Samsung 95 Bravo on the right. We've got a 4K Fire Stick plugged into each of these devices. Each of these devices has a 4K Fire Stick, using a remote to navigate back and forth on each of them just to keep some image consistency on. So at this point, y'all tell me what y'all think. Now, realistically, I want to just talk about the C2. So instead of me just standing and talking and we're not really having anything to look at, I just want to know what you guys think about the LG lineup. Let's not even think about the shootout. Don't even talk about the shootout. Let's just talk about what you think about LG at this present time. When you look at these two colossal TVs in the middle and to the right, this is a C2, this isn't even the G2. What does this look like to you? The best I could do is show you steals, because obviously I'm not going to play this content and not be able to do what I need to do on this video. But what do you think of the C2, man? It's not a G2, a C2. Everything is set on the warm. So let me give y'all that punch y'all like from the Samsung. Let me give you that punch. Let's go to the settings. We're going to go to, there's dynamic. That's what we love to see, right? We want to see that. Oh, it's bright. It's vivid. Let's go back to that Saul. That's that Samsung punch. That's what we see when we go into the store. That's what we see when we go into the store. We go into that store, that big box retailer, that mom and pop shop. That's what we see. All right. So this is what we see after the update. That's what we see after the update. And it looks pretty dang gone good. My TV was updated in the video earlier. When I sent you guys that photo of the post, my TV was already updated. That update was not for the one that you said would nerf my TV. My TV has been updated since I did the video weeks ago with the Xbox app. Yes, I had no problem with updating my TV. No issues with it. Because I'm gonna use the TV the way that they intend me to use it. You know what I mean? It's a gaming TV for me. It's a 55 class gaming TV. That's what it is for me. I'm not hung up on the S95B as a movie TV, so I'm sorry. That's why my talking points went in the direction they did. I think this is perfect in 55 class. Some great dialogue and conversation from you gentlemen to agree to. But I want to know what you think. When we're looking at this, these three, what are we thinking? Now, I'm going to tell you what I'm seeing up to this point. The Sony is superior, and it's by a large enough margin for me to be able to look at it, and I can distinguish this TV. There's a look about this TV that is just different. Do you agree? Mm-hmm. Say it again.
I agree.
You don't gotta believe me, guys. Listen, my camera is a Sony ZV-1. It's no bias. I don't know how to set my camera to make it look perfect for you guys. I am saying that to be 100% real. The Samsung looks more sharp than this LG. I can tell you that. It's a fact. It's a fact. The colors do look more pure than the LG. But the LG looks good. Not a G2. Where is Resident Evil gonna be? Recently added. Let's see if I can get down to it. There we go. The LG looks good to me, guys. There's enough detail there for me to enjoy it. I wanna know what the Samsung looks like if I put it on dynamic right here, though. Shit. Shit. Can you even see it? What's the term they use? Blown out? They're going to say it's blown out. I don't know. It don't look blown out to me. It look bright as hell, though. This is what you see when you go in that store. Listen, go back to my video. I'm going to card it in. In the beginning of the video, I showed y'all what Spider-Man looked like. This is what I was seeing. God, good God Almighty. Man, look at them colors. I don't even want to turn these other TVs on no kind of dynamic. I can't even take it. This is where it's going to reside, though. More dim, more warm. You know, it's turned down a little bit. The dynamic turns everything up. It even looked like it turned the sharpness up. The Darkwing was bright as a moon. Shit. The worst Darkwing Duck was white as white. Cocaine white. Pure. Raw. But what do you guys think? I don't know. That's what I want to know. That's what this is all about. Tell me what you think. Personally, if this was a gaming TV, what I say earlier, at the end of the video earlier, if this was a gaming TV I was buying, and I knew that I was predominantly going to be playing on PC, which TV am I buying? My bad, I forgot what remote I was using. Where's the turtles at? I don't know if it's anywhere near here. I don't know. I wanted to get the turtles on there. I got too much damn content on here. Look at old Matlock. But if I'm buying it, this is a gaming PC, I'm going with the guy on the left. The guy on the left is tried and true technology. Loyalty means something to me. If you have been good to me and you have made a product that has been tried and true, that's what I want. If it wasn't for LG doing what they did to Samsung in 2014, 2015, 2016, 2017, 2018, 2019, 2020, 2021, we wouldn't have this TV on the right. Tell me if I'm wrong. And now we ready to throw it away, huh? I'm listening to people write comments telling me that the TV on the left ain't even worth talking about. What is wrong with you people? What is wrong with you people? How is it not worth talking about? What are you looking at? If I'm playing on consoles and I know I'm watching movies, I'm going on the guy on the right. The guy on the right is going to give me a nice overall package. I'm going to feel comfortable about this TV when I go home and I watch this. I know I got some creme de la creme shit. I know I got some quality. I know it's going to do good in all type of aspects. If my bag is together, though, I don't think it's a question. Big dog is in the middle. If my bag is together, I'm going with the guy in the middle. Because he's better. Yeah. And guess what? He's good enough in gaming. On PC and console. Without G-Sync. Without FreeSync tags on it. It's good enough. And it's still going to look better than everything else on this planet. Pun intended. Captain Planet. You know what I'm saying? That boy in the middle is the one. Y'all tell me what y'all think, man. We just having fun. Listen, guys, I got a premiere video coming up tomorrow, man. Arcade Stick. I cannot force you guys to watch content you don't want to watch. But understand this, guys. This is my second time being on YouTube. Thanks to you guys, I'm above 6,000 subscribers. I have been here before. I let that channel go because it was a lot of negativity. And I did not want to see myself today with kids seeing me say all and do all the things that I was doing on that channel. So we here with positivity, right? That's what it's all about. It's all about positivity. Thank you guys for getting me there. Let's continue to grind and grow together. To all you LG lovers out there, listen, I ain't forgot about y'all. We got much more content coming and we are going to be doing actual comparisons of these, but I wanted to give you guys another talking point video. I want to know what you guys think in the comment section below. If you didn't like this video, leave me some constructive criticism. Tell me what you think I could have did better. If you guys are not subscribed, go ahead and do it. What you waiting for? If you are subscribed, make sure you hit the notification bell. I'm going to catch you guys on the next one. Max love.